Hey there, welcome to my channel. My name is Dee Dee. On this channel, I cover hearing loss related topics from my own experience. I may share some tips and strategies to improve hearing health and communication, or I may just share my challenges with my own hearing loss. The goal for this channel is to create a community where people can come and watch videos so that they don't feel like they're alone with their hearing loss. Be sure to turn on your captioning down at the bottom so that you can read what I'm saying. And if you can, go ahead and enlarge your screen so that you can see me and read my lips well. If you have the option to get direct audio to your hearing aids, if you wear them, through a streamer or whatever you have, from your computer or whatever device you're using so that you can hear me the best. Now today's topic is four things every person with hearing loss needs to know. Number one is to accept your hearing loss. Many people will ignore their hearing loss and just say, no, the TV isn't that loud. They may think that other people are just mumbling. Or simply they just don't want to tell anybody about their hearing loss because of the stigma. Usually family members can pick up when somebody else in their family has hearing difficulties, but many times we just don't want to listen to them. Now, I grew up with moderate to severe hearing loss, and I was conditioned to hide my hearing so that I could fit in with the hearing kids. I had to learn to accept my hearing so that I could feel good about me. Number two, expert. Who is the hearing loss expert? I'm here to tell you that it's you. You are the only one that knows your hearing loss the best. If you don't do tip number one, which is to accept your hearing loss, then that will delay the journey into becoming that expert. So taking the time to understand your own hearing loss will help you understand the world around you. Now, no one will tell you how you hear. So say there's a bird chirping and somebody will say, oh, listen to that bird, nice high pitch sound. And you're like, what? So no one will tell you when the doorbell rings. You are the only one that describe what you can hear and what you can't hear. So first, accepting your hearing loss, and then you become the expert. But then you accept yourself as that unique individual with your hearing loss. No one wants to be like somebody else, right? Okay, next tip, number three, who to tell. So who do you want to tell about your hearing loss? The most important people to tell about your hearing loss are the people that you communicate with on a daily basis. Now that can be your family members, your close friends, and even your coworkers. One of the most important people to tell about your hearing loss is your audiologist. Your audiologist will take the time to listen to you and understand your lifestyle so that he or she can create this plan of what is best to deliver hearing to you through hearing aids, to assistive listening devices, whatever that may be. They will come up with the tools and say, here, try this out. When an audiologist does this, this is called hearing health. Who doesn't want to have a healthy hearing loss? That's a good name for the channel. You need to educate how you hear to other people. Every person with hearing loss will find a unique way of trying to explain how they hear and how best to communicate with them. Many people with normal hearing can hear sound, so many sounds, but they're able to drown out those sounds to the background and focus on the sounds that they want to hear. Now that's a whole different story with somebody with hearing loss. Hearing aids do not like background noise. It is our job as people with hearing loss to explain to other people how we hear and what our limitations are. Do not make everything perfect. Educating about your hearing loss helps with relationships. If we explain how we hear and we communicate our needs, then that makes that communication between another person and you better. Some communication examples that I like to share with you is, for example, you're looking at me now, you're facing me, and I have this bright light on my face so that you can read my lips. I'm not turning away from you so that you have to try to struggle to read my lips behind my head. You can request for somebody to come closer to you and not to be talking to you from another room. Ask people please not to cover their mouth. Some people will chew with their food in the mouth or gum. Stress the importance of a quiet environment so that you can hear the best. A nice quiet area without a lot of reverberation. Hearing aids do not like echo. Tell people that raising their voice, the tone of their voice, to a high level does not make it better for you to hear. A normal voice is the best way for us to hear and to explain, not to over-enunciate, which is this exaggeration of our lips. No, it's not cool at all. just don't do it. Please don't do that. So you need normal lips, you need normal speech, and you need a nice level tone. That's all it takes in a quiet environment, and you face me and yada, yada, yada. Number four, repeat. You need to repeat often. And the reason to repeat is that we live in a world where there is a lot of people with normal hearing, which is referred to as the hearing world. And within the hearing world, it is extremely easy for people to forget that there's somebody in the room with hearing loss. We repeat our hearing loss challenges to other people so that we can reinforce that kind of activity, memory type of thing. So it's going to become a habit to understand that you have a hearing loss and they have to remember to talk to you in the ways that you ask them. No one will remember one time. So over and over again. Some people can remember on the first time, but that's rare. The four things that we covered today is that you need to accept your hearing loss and remember that you're awesome because you have hearing loss, right? Just because you have hearing loss, you're no different than anybody else in this world. I mean, you're just awesome. You're unique and cool. Number two, expert. You are the expert, and the only way to become the expert is to take the time and explore why and how and where in all these different areas in your life, how you hear and what you don't hear, and get out there and learn, like listen to the birds, and you know, if there's a dog barking, where is it coming from? And I don't know, you'll figure it out. Number three, educate. So educating on communication strategies like we've mentioned, which is please face me, don't talk to me from another room, don't talk behind me, don't chew with your mouthful. And you just tell them, please don't, you know, just do what I say. Number four, we're going to repeat. We're going to continuously repeat what our difficulties are, what our limitations are, so that they will remember and they will accommodate you. There's nothing wrong with somebody accommodating you because, like, why not? You're perfect, you're awesome, and you matter, right? I have been hard of hearing since the age of four, and I still have to educate those who have been in my life most of that time to this day. So educate. Okay, so that's it for this video. If you found this content helpful, then go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and so that you will know about the next video coming up. Okay, that's it, folks. Take care. Bye.